Welcome back. You're still watching sports this morning. We're broadcasting live from Channels TV Sports Center in Lagos, Nigeria. So much to talk about. We've started taking a look at Team Nigeria's preparations in athletics for the 2016 Rio Olympics. It's not just for the athletes who are participating at the games, for athletes that are also aspiring to qualify. Right now, as we speak, they're at the High Performance Center in Port Harcourt. They're with the coaches. They're trying to, you know, dot the I's and cross the T's. Can Nigeria go to the Olympics and impress in athletics? That's the talk this morning. We want you to talk to us on Twitter for Channels _ Sports and on Facebook for Channels Life in Sports. And we know that Arsenal fans, they cannot wait for the Champions League game tonight right here at Channels TV Sports Center. We have tagged it. Can the Gunners survive? You think Arsenal can stun Barcelona tonight? You can also talk to us as regards that one on Twitter. We're still Channels _ Sports and on Facebook for Channels Life in Sports. I love the Champions League football night, guys. Yeah. Cannot wait for it.
I'm not sure Arsenal fans are actually looking forward to this game. My mates that I've spoken to that are Arsenal fans, they just want the inevitable to be over with so they can move on to the next thing.
What are you talking about?
I don't know.
I'm sure Tommy Manuel will not agree to that.
Tommy Manuel is in the house of the paper review, but he's also a big, big Arsenal fan.
It's great to be here. Good morning, everybody. Yeah. The good thing is that it's a talking point. Right. If you're not playing the Champions League, you're not among the big boys.
What do you mean?
And that's just the basic truth. So
Manchester United is not.
But a lot of people have forgotten that.
Thursday night football.
A lot of people have forgotten that en route to this stage, Arsenal passed through a lot of challenges. And it defeated Bayern Munich. But what was the result? Second leg in Munich, that's understood, they lost. But they were able to get the basic result. The media space is so occupied with MSN, everything. But what happens tonight if Arsenal should stun Barcelona? For me, I think the Barca defense is my biggest worry because it's very suspicious.
Yes.
Now, Arsenal has a very great team moving forward in Ozil, Giroud, and Sanchez.
Okay.
So if they take their chances, they could stun. Now, coming to the midfield, the dominance of the backer team, understanding their flair, and their energy, and also it translated from the midfield to the attack, like Messi and the midfielder. So it's going to give Arsenal a very big problem. So whether you like it or not, it is a match that is going to be very interesting. Even Messi, even their coaches, they are not the way the fans and other people have dominating the media space that they just say white one. We saw Barca struggled at the weekend.
Yeah, against La Palma.
We saw Barca struggle at the weekend.
That's the La Liga,
and that is why Arsenal. We saw what Arsenal did to Leicester and came again and play against us. Excuse me. It's a function of football. You were here when we said Nigeria were going to destroy. A Guinea will do this
it's
at the end of the day.
No,
it's football.
It's different.
It's football. Tomorrow.
Which Sunday only said me realize it was just chance.
Okay, tomorrow morning you will call me on this program live.
Right.
I'll be at home watching.
All right. I'm not saying the impossible cannot happen.
You spoke about
Barca's defense being a suspect. But I'm also worried about Arsenal defense also.
Yeah, sure.
You're not gonna take a
pass
and go against Emerson.
I listen to what you guys
said. Not even Gabriel.
But nobody's giving Arsenal a chance. But the truth of the matter, let's end it like this. Truth of the matter, Barca are favorites, whether we like it or not.
Yeah.
They have one of the best attacking in the world.
Yeah, they
have the best.
Yeah.
There's no doubt about that. But this is football. It's about who make use of their chances. And also, but there's a possibility of an upset. For me, I go for a 2-1 win or a 2-2 draw. But Arsenal losing.
Arsenal?
Yeah. Okay. But Arsenal losing today is going to be very deep.
Oh,
he's not going to happen.
Arsenal is not losing.
But Arsenal is either winning 2-1 or a 2-2.
Oh, incredible. Interesting. Just to, help you a bit.
I like you leaving it at that. Yeah, I just like you leaving it at that.
Just to give add a bit of confidence for Toby Mano here. Lionel Messi
has not scored against Peter. A lot of factors.
If we decide to talk about this matter, we'll probably.
Yeah, we don't come to it.
I wouldn't say
that, please. Don't come into it. Let's just understand where Toby Manor is coming from. So let's go to the paper.
Yes.
Toby, all the best. 2-1 or 2-2, right?
Yeah.
We'll be back to talk about it.
Definitely. Okay, let's go straight to the papers now. And we're starting with the Sporting Life.
Yeah.
It's the Battle of the Pharaohs again. Eagle Stars revolt against Olise. Wow. That's like a bombshell.
A few weeks back, I spoke with some of the players. And some of the players, what they said was, in as much they don't want to get involved with the battle with the NFF and Olise, that the coach should not use them as a yardstick to say, okay, they actually, none of them, about three, I spoke with three in confidence, and they said they did not specifically demand that they are pulling out.
Okay.
So that because their families and friends have started calling them, is it true you people are threatening that you are not playing? And there are 1,001 Nigerian players that want to play for Nigeria. Like the young man has scored against Man U. Mm-hmm. If you give him a call today, he'll take the next flight to
play. Aaron Samuel is still waiting.
There's one Fernando Adi that plays very well in MLS. We have even Ajagun. Mm-hmm. We have our players doing well. Now, everybody coming up. So these players actually said, in as much they are not happy that they have not been paid, the coach and administration are fighting, they should not be put in the middle. That's just the basic of this.
Okay,
but
so
revolting,
it's not really a revolt.
He's not really a revolt. They're just trying to make themselves take a... they don't want to get involved. And Olise has apologized. The NFF has said, okay, let's move forward. And everybody, even the media, we all have said, okay, let's support. Because we cannot afford to lose that match.
Yeah.
That match is a function. We determine a lot of things in our football. We have a lot of young of generation players that are translating to big clubs in Europe now. They are this under 17, under 23 team. We have under the Super Eagles. And we're also building a team. Because if we don't qualify, we will find ourselves in a difficult group in the World Cup. At the end of it, we'll not qualify for the World Cup. So the next 3 years, we'll not have good football in Nigeria. It's going to kill income. It's going to kill the media. It's going to kill competition. It's going to kill youth development. And also, so in all, Olise cannot fail. NFL don't have an excuse to fail. And with the media, we must support. We all need help to make sure that we move this country forward.
That's right.
Okay. Yeah, let's go straight to the sports day now.
Okay. Yeah. Let's see. A lot of interesting stories in today's sports day. But I'll go for this one on page four. Since we're talking about Super Eagles player, Iheanacho travels for UEFA Champions League clash.
Yeah.
I think it's heartwarming and interesting.
Yeah, he's good.
Our boy doing well.
Yeah, it's good for him. It's good for his career. So he talks about the same thing we discussed a few weeks back. We need to believe in our own players. Just like the way the coaching crew of Manchester City, especially Pellegrini, believes so much in this young guy, Iheanacho. Iheanacho, like I said, if we have Iheanacho playing as the supporting striker to Ighalo, playing as the attacking midfielder, why, like Olise insisted, Mikel must play his defensive role with Onazi. So two of them stay at the back line with Ahmed Musa on the right and Simon on the left, or even a Victor Moses on the left. We have a very fluid attack with transition from midfield to the attack. The biggest problem we had in Chan was there was no transmission from the midfield to the attack. And also, there's a lacuna between the midfield to the defense. So what do we do when we are not with the ball? So that's why we saw the likes of Alimi and other people struggling, Chimakas at the back struggling. Now that the young man is going to play Champions League, it's also giving that extra edge to play among the big boys. That is the best league in the world. And that's why people like Manchester United are lamenting that they're playing Thursday football.
Okay, let's go to... I'm not saying anything about that. Let's go to the Complete Sports newspaper now. Everyone talking to Coach Sunday only said, what's going on? And when Clemens Vestal speaks, it doesn't come easy. Vestal declares war on Olise.
What?
Wants NFF to clamp down on Eagles coach should Nigeria fail to beat Egypt. And this man has been there, done that with Nigerian football. I'm thinking maybe he knows what he's talking about.
No, Vestal has always been critical of any, even he did that against Keshi, even Bonfrejo. I am not an apologist of any. They've done theirs, they've gone. In as much that Olise failed or fumbled or and he has apologized, we all make mistakes. I was here a few weeks ago, I was ranting. I even wrote a personal mail. I did a lot of things and I talked to you. But now we don't have any excuse to fail. Olise has said something. But the problem we have in this country is that we shift the goalpost. Olise was wrong in his approach. He was wrong with some of the way he said, but he made some sense with some of the issues he raised. But in this country, we shift the goalpost, then we look at the alternative, then we concentrate all our energy on the alternative without remembering the issues. Mm. Now, the NFF should make sure that, like he said, I was listening to him this morning, he said the crowd he saw in Kano.
That's right.
If we can have that same crowd in Kaduna to play football, then we have that settled down. The match issues, bonus and everything. Now, the dollars is very, very expensive. Mm. Now, getting money, let the FA put their hearts together, get money. Let the media also come to support. Then, monitoring your players, you don't need to travel out and do everything. We don't do whatever we need to do. We must win. Everybody must support Lise. Mm. So West Ham should just go and sleep and forget Nigerian football.
You know, the only thing I heard from that conversation, we must win. Very important Nigeria wins that game against Egypt. So much speculation as regards his career. Chisom Chikatara, he's talking to us this morning. He says, I remain Abia Warriors player. Chan 2016 Hero speaks on wider deal. But at the moment, he says, I still play for Abia Warriors.
There's a good thing. It's just unfortunate that our players just jump into any offers they see. The issue at the channel, I expected the young man immediately finish the channel. Just look at offers. I just jumped at the available ones. And the club sanctioned it. They went to Morocco. It was not as juicy as promised. And I saw the handwriting on the wall. Quickly, the young man came back. And our league have started. And he needs to play regular football and also to be in contention to play for the Super Eagles. When he plays for the Super Eagles, he has the opportunity to go to mainstream Europe or even play in the Northern Africa, where most of our players are going. But it's good he's back home with Abia Warriors.
Mm. Okay, let's talk about another Super Eagles player, retired. Emmanuel Emenike speaking this morning said, I would have been disappointed if I didn't score. Eagles star speaks on Hammers Breeze. Emmanuel Emenike, I'm sure he's one player that when Coach Sunday only sees him now, starts wondering, why did this guy retire?
He said it this morning. He said he's happy for him that he scored those two goals, and his work rate. It's just unfortunate that he's no more available. But like Olisa was saying, he's a good player who has what it takes to also go and do well in the team. But he's good for his confidence. He's good that he's combining well with Victor Moses, and the coach believes so much. You could see the celebration on the coach when he scored. He believes so much in him.
All right, let me quickly ask you this. You know, do you think when the coach eventually releases his squad list, you will have any surprises? We just talked about Victor Moses, Emmanuel Emenike. Mm. Do you think because of the situation now that he will be under pressure to, you know, maybe recall some of those players who are well experienced?
No. Like he said, the players like Victor Moses, he said he's watching Victor because he wants to see the consistency, because Victor is prone to injury.
Yeah.
He just came back, and he just, before now and then, he doesn't want to mention a name, and later we will not see the player to come over. But there are some players he's monitoring. See, where he has problems is the defense and the combination. The attack, our players are doing very well. The midfield is almost set, but the defense, the back line, who's going to play the two central? Obuabuna is back now. Omero is back. Are we going to see the combination back? Then will Akas or Echejile take over the left foot back? And let's just see there. So he has option now. He said he's been to Holland, he's watched a couple of boys. He's been to Belgium, watch two of our boys, and also going to England, speak to Mikel.
That's right.
And see how to see Mikel playing to that holding role of a defensive midfielder, which is doing well with it. The team is in Chelsea now, is built around Mikel in the midfield. It's the engine room now, detecting the midfield defensively, and that's why Chelsea is doing well. And Mikel has been talking everywhere, attacking Mourinho, and still talking about it. Like yesterday, he said he wants the 99% of the team wants needs to stay. So, but it's a good thing for the confidence of our player. If our players are doing well, we always get the ball. He said he still need to step up his game tactically to make sure that, okay, when you have every other team, all things be equal, everything is set, now we should get the results.